she was not able to stand. The Bible says in the book of Isaiah 8, verse 10. The book of Isaiah 8, verse 10, the Bible says, take counsel together, and it shall not come to do not. Speak the word, and it shall not stand. For God is with us. When they take counsel together, and it shall not come, not speak the word, and it shall not stand, for God is with us. That is Isaiah 8, verse 10. Hallelujah. The Bible says, verse 9, let's start from verse 9. The Bible says, associate yourself, O ye people, and ye shall be broken in pieces, and give ears, O ye of far countries. Grind yourself, and ye shall be broken in pieces. Grind yourself, and take counsel together, and it shall come to naught. Speak the word, and it shall not come, it shall not stand, for God is with us. God is with us. The word of the devil, it will not stand. Let me read from the book of 1 Samuel 17, verse 23. 1 Samuel 17, verse 23. The Bible says, there was this Philistine man who was coming in front of the children of Israel. 40 days he was exalting himself, calling the defied the Israel. Now the time came when David heard him. This man was shouting as he was talking with them. Goliath the Philistine, the champion of Goliath, came out from the Philistine ranks. Then David heard him shout his usual taunt to the army of Israel. This man called Goliath, he was coming to curse the children of Israel 40 days, every day. Now, the Bible says, David heard him. David, a young boy, heard Goliath. What, with his taunt, talking every day, his wicked words, cursing the children of Israel. Then David says, who is this pagan Philistine anyway? That allowed to divide the arms of the living God. You see, this man, he was dividing the Israel, the children of Israel. And David heard him cursing and exalting himself 40 days coming in front. When the children of Israel saw him, they were running back. Now, when David heard him, the Bible says, when David heard him, he said, who is this pagan and circumcised Philistine? David, a young boy, just a boy, when he had this Goliath taunting his words all the day, all 40 days, 1 month and 10 days, this man, every day, he could come and scare the children of Israel. Now, David was so hungry in his spirit. He looked at him. He said, is it because you are so big? Is this because you are so giant? Who are you? You pagan and circumcised Philistine, defying the holy people of God. You are the devil. You have no power. Remember, the Bible says that we have been given power. We have been given key to rule and rule on earth and in heaven. So now, when David looked at this man, he was very angry. David was furiously angry about this man. How wrong will you divide these people? How wrong will this man come to divide you? How wrong will this problem in you all the time? David, that's why I have a video called We Want a David of Today. So this young man, he was a boy. He's a short young boy. He was very young. And he was short, not even big like Goliath. He was, you know, a boy and a short little boy. When he heard Goliath, he was furiously annoyed. He was very angry with Goliath. So he said, then when Goliath looked at David, he said, you dog, you know, that's why the word will not stand. That's why the title, speak the word, it will not stand. Now, if you look at verse 43, Goliath, when he looked at David, he said, am I a dog? He roared at David that you come to me with a stick. And he cursed David. He cursed David by the name of his God. Goliath cursed David in the name of his God. He cursed David in the name of his God. So he uses his gods to curse David. He was using his gods to scare the children of Israel. Now, David was a man, you cannot scare him. He doesn't care who you are. He is a man of God, full of Holy Spirit and power. So when he looked at Goliath, he said, you curse me with your gods. Who is that God? My God is big than your God. Today I'm going to kill you physically, not spiritually. So Goliath thought that it's a joke. It is a mere joke. This boy, I just hold her with my two fingers and kill her and break her to pieces and break him to pieces. What is this they are showing me? I am a child with all this. Then the God of Israel, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, arise against Goliath. His word that he cursed David, David was not scared. David responded, replied to him. He said, David replied to the Philistine, you come to me with sword, spear, and javelin, but I come to you in the name of the Lord of heaven, heaven's army, the God of armies of Israel, whom you have defied. Today the Lord will conquer you, and I will kill you and cut off your head. And then I will give the dead body to your men, to the birds and wild animals, and the whole world will know that there is a God in Israel. So David told this idiot, this wicked man, that you come to me with spear, with the sword, to kill me, I will kill you. Today I'm going to kill you so that the whole world will know, and I will give your bodies to the birds of the air to hit you. So David, Goliath just look at David, because Goliath believes his God, that his God will deliver and will fight for him. He believes the gods. That's why I'm telling you, gods, the devil does not have power. Goliath believes his God. He worships Satan. He believes Satan is. So now here, the Bible says, powers of darkness and powers of God. Powers of darkness and powers of the right. So here they are exchanging power, physically, not spiritually. The little boy went with a stone, with a string, and hit the Goliath on the forehead. Goliath fell down. David jumped on him and cut his head, because his word would not stand. He cast David, scared David, but his word was not stand. David come against it. David come and bring him down and kill him. His words, the words of that devil, it will not stand. The devil will say anything, like what people have been writing to me, cursing me, saying words of me. It will not stand. It will not function. It will not work. As long as you remain in the word of God, any very word of that devil, that's why the Bible says in Numbers 23:23, there shall be no enchantment or divination against you, against your family, against you, in the name of Jesus. When you stand with the word of God, they will speak, but it will not stand. Let me show you another example, whereby this man called Zenabab. This man, he was so wicked. He was threatening the children of Israel. He wrote a letter to Ezekiah, and he threatened them. Look at what he said in the book of Isaiah, Isaiah 37, verse 5. Sennacherib wrote a letter. This is what he said. After King Ezekiel's official delivered the king's message to Isaiah, the prophet Leprai said to your master, this is what the Lord says, do not be disturbed by this blameless speech against me from the Syrian king's messenger. Listen, I myself will move against him, and the king will receive message that he is needed at home. So he will return to his land when I would have killed with a sword. Zenabab this man, he was so wicked, and they wrote a letter threatening Isaiah, the children of Israel, and they said that Isaiah is deceiving them, that he's a God who would kill, who would destroy them. Then Isaiah, when he got this letter, he represented his letter to heaven. And after Isaiah received the letter from the messenger and he read it, he went up to the Lord's temple and spread it out before the Lord. And Isaiah prayed this prayer before the Lord. O Lord of heaven, hear me. O God of heavens, hear me. God of Israel, you are enthroned between the mighty cherubim and Jerahim. You alone, you are God of all the kingdom of the earth. You alone created the heavens and the earth. Bend down, O Lord, and listen. Open your ears. Open your eyes, O Lord, and see this Zenekab words to defense against the living God. Sennacherib. Listen to the word of Sennacherib. This Sennacherib has threatened the children of Israel with the letters. So Ezekiel spread the letter to heaven. That's why you need to write your prayer request. We will present it to heaven for your needs. When he prayed like this prayer, then the word of God came to Ezekiel, Isaiah. Here is verse 33. The Bible says, and this is what the Lord says about the king of Syria. His army will not enter Jerusalem. It will not even shoot an arrow at it. Now, look at this. What happened? The Bible says, now, the Lord Almighty, you see, when this man threatened the children of Israel, wrote a bad letter to them, Ezekiel spread the letter to heaven, and he prayed. And what happened? God, the word of God came to Ezekiel, Isaiah, and told Ezekiel, don't worry, this man will not touch you, will not even do anything to you. Don't worry, I have handed him to you. Now, the Bible says, what happened? Because his words would not stand, his threatening word, the words of the devil, the words of the enemy, the word of the Satan would not stand. The Bible says, hallelujah, praise the name of Jesus. The Bible says in verse 36, that is Isaiah 37, verse 36. The Bible says, the night the angel of the Lord went out to the Assyrian camp and killed 185,000 Syrian soldiers. When the serving Assyrian woke up in the next morning, they found corpses everywhere. Then King Sennacherib of Syria broke camp and returned to his own land. Now he was killed by his own children, his own sons. So now you see, one angel went to the camp of Syrian and killed all of them. That's why I was praying and thinking and imagining how did the angel did that. This is what is happening. So don't let the word of the devil to threaten you. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Jesus, you are wonderful. When we thank God, we praise him. They speak the word, it will not stand. The word of the devil will not stand against the children of God. When God is with you, no one will stand with you. If the words of the devil, you know, the devil always scare you, speak his word to fear. The Bible says he roar like a lion, but it's not a lion. It to scare you, to make you fear. When you fear, then he will get you. But when you stand firm with the word of God, the devil will not defeat you. Therefore, today, tonight, look at what happened to the night. The night when the armies were in the camp, all of them, the angel went there and slaughtered them, everyone, because they were against God. They divided the God of Israel. Any power, hallelujah, praise the name of Jesus. I pray that in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that every witchcraft utterance and projection made against you be overthrown in the name of Jesus. Any power, any mouth speaking against you, let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. Any plans of the devil, witchcraft protection against your life and your family, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Oh God, make your